We're going to have a look at how you investigate what software version is installed on your Ziton ZP3 fire alarm control panel. This can be useful if you're looking for technical support or spare parts for your system. Sometimes it can be useful in the office if we know what you have installed. So, menu, one for operator, two for reports to display, and then we're looking at two for software version. So we see here it's version 3.12, and then if you need to know what's on your peripheral boards, you can push F1 there. Okay, so pretty straightforward. If you need any more information, contact us in the office or email info@comsec.ie. Thanks. Today we're going to have a look at performing a lamp test on the Ziton ZP3 fire alarm control panel. So we do this in the operator menu, which is menu, one here for operator, and then we have an option here, number four for lamp test, so we just push four. So we can see all our LEDs lighting up, and we know that they're all functional on the panel. When you're done, it's simple, you just press escape, and then to get out of these menus, just home. We'll have a look at the ZP3 fire alarm control panel and how to do a button test on that system. So into menu, and we're interested in the operator menu again, and we go into the keypad test mode here. So we're now in a mode, and we'll see here it tells us what's the last button we push. So if I push one, we see that it's one. If I push the accept button, it tells us we've pushed the accept. The disable button, so if you have a button sticking or you're not sure if all the buttons are functioning correctly, this will tell you. So it can be useful sometimes to have a look at this. And then when you're done, you press the same key twice. So any key will get you back, and you're back into the operator. And when you're done, it's the home menu. So if you need any more information on the Ziton ZP3, give us a call in the office or info@comsec.ie. We're going to have a look at a detector point status from the operator menu on the Ziton ZP3 fire alarm control panel. So it's menu, one for operator, and then we go reports to display, and we go point status. So this kind of gives us a broad overview of the condition of a detector attached to the system. So 1001 on our demo panel is a heat sensor, and it's telling us it's healthy and it's set to sensitivity 2. Nothing connected on number 2, and we have a multi-sensor here on addressed for number 3, so it's a smoke set for medium sensitivity and heat. So it just gives you an overview of how the detectors are doing on the system. So when you're done with all that, it's the home button to get you back to the normal screen. So if you need any more information, it's info@comsec.ie or contact us in the office. We'll have a look at disabling a smoke detector on the Ziton ZP3 fire alarm control panel. If you need any more information on this, give us a call in the office or info@comsec.ie. So we go menu, and we want to go into the maintenance menu here, which is number 2. And on our control panel, we've the code here set as 1, 2, 3, 4. Chances are this will be different on your own system. So again, if you're looking for codes or things like that, give us a call in the office. We might be able to help you out. So when you come in here, you see a selection of menus, but the one that we're looking for is Edit Disabled. And today we just want to do a point. So it's 1 for point, and then you enter the point address. So that could be anything here. So we go 1010. If your panel's networked, you'll see you have an option to add in the panel address as well, so you can disable equipment across the network. So we're just interested in this for the moment. So we have currently it's enabled. So we want to do 1 for disable, press enter. And then as always, the most important step here, we press home and we'll see that it's saving. So that's your detector is now disabled. So if we look at detectors disabled on the system, and we can do viewpoints, and it tells us here disable point 1010, and it's an interface. So info@comsec.ie or call us in the office. Thanks. Today we're going to have a look at identifying where an alarm has activated on the Ziton ZP3 fire alarm panel, and we'll go through the silencing, the viewpoints, the accept and reset procedures. So I'll just set off the alarm here on our mock-up. So we can see here from the display that the fire alarm zone is the ground floor, so it's zone 001, ground floor. And if we push the viewpoints button, it tells us exactly what's happened here. So it's device 1005, it's a call point, and it's the ground floor stair B lobby. So assuming we know what has caused the activation, we can silence the alarms. So silencing the alarms will stop the bells ringing straight away. And then when you're happy that you've resolved your issue or the smoke is cleared from the detector, you can do accept followed by reset. And that's your fire alarm system back to normal. Thanks very much. It's www.comsec.ie or info@comsec.ie if you want to contact us. Thanks. Bye. Today we're going to have a look at identifying a detector fault on the Ziton ZP3 fire alarm control panel. So I've removed the detector here on our demo panel, and it showed me that we have a fault coming up on zone number one, which is the ground floor. And if I push the viewpoints button, it should tell me the details of the fault. So we have a device offline, it's 0.1002. We know it's a multi-sensor and it's in the entrance lobby. So the obvious thing to investigate would be maybe attend to the entrance lobby and see, has the detector actually just been removed? If it's something else, if the detector is still there, we can dig into the analog values, and we'll go into that in a different video. So if you have any questions, contact us in the office or info@comsec.ie. Thanks very much. Today we're going to have a look at running the detector calibration on a Ziton ZP3 fire alarm control panel. So we go into the menu here, and we're going to go into maintenance. On our demo panel here, I have the code set at 1, 2, 3, 4. Your site's probably different. If you're stuck for codes for these panels, give us a call in the office. We might be able to help you out. Press enter, it'll get you in here. And we see here option number 6 is calibrate detectors. So you might want to do this if you've changed the number of detectors on the system. The calibration runs every day automatically. I think it's set at midnight by default. But if you've changed the number of detectors on the panel, it's worth doing a calibrate so that the panel knows what's connected to it and it gives it the current set of readings. So we'll do the calibrate, and it'll just count down from 4 as it runs through its process here. And that's you then, all done. The system itself will log you out of the maintenance menu after a couple of minutes, but if you want to go in and do something else, you do your menu again and 2, it's not going to ask you for the code again this time.